Not all professional wrestling organizations have an off-season, but my company, Chikara, does, and I'm here to make an argument for it. I'm Mike Quackenbush, and this is Till We Make It. Today on the program, I want to put forth to you my argument for why pro wrestling organizations all need to offer an off-season. And there are four main things I want to cover. Among all the powerful virtues of an off-season, it allows you the opportunity to assess, to evaluate, to course correct, and to recharge. And these are all exceptionally valuable. During each off-season, I have the opportunity to go back and assess what Chikara did in the year prior. And if you're in a consistent grind of planning an event, having an event, and then planning the next event, having that event, and then planning the next event, and then having that event, you don't have enough time to look back with any true hindsight and assess the work that you've just done. What went well? What didn't go well? What are you gonna do about it? Those are the kinds of things that you can assess during an off-season that a never-ending cycle, a non-stop grind, never really allows time for. So even though sometimes it can feel like a chore, I've got to do that assessment, and then I need to evaluate. I evaluate my entire team. During the off-season, I'm going to evaluate in two different ways. Number one, I have to come to this decision. Who is the worst performer in my ensemble? Who is the least reliable? Who's the worst for team morale? And what can I do to change that? What can be done to turn that around? Understanding that every once and again, the real answer to that is maybe we have to cut somebody. So my off-season allows for some really hard work. I've got to evaluate my team and make a decision about how I'm going to challenge some of my least performing members to do better or decide if we're going to move forward without them. And on the other side of that equation, I've also got to evaluate the people who are my top performers, the ones who always deliver, who are doing the best possible job. And then I think, what can I do to reward them for their reliable service? Could I create a more robust storyline to feature their character and add more prestige to their work? That's one of many ways that I can reward somebody who proves to be a top performer. And without the benefit of hindsight, I would never be able to honestly evaluate that. The separation the off-season allows me from active duty is the only way I can make those evaluations accurately. Once I have completed both assessment and evaluation, that's when I've got a course correct for the year that lies ahead. And granted, off-season might just mean looking 90 days in the future. It could just mean 180 days in the future. But my personal process is I look at the next year as a whole. And your process, I do appreciate, might be a little different. When I'm able to reflect on what happened in the year past in terms of individual performances and the larger things, whether they went well or they did not go well, it allows me to course correct. I might decide, you know what, we need more of this and we need less of that. We should feature this more prominently, we should feature that less prominently. And I can course correct because to me, every season of Chikara that I make is just an experiment. I know the end result that I would like to get to. And if I'm not constantly refining my process, deciding, well, I need a little bit more of this and a little bit less of that, I'm not gonna get any closer to that desired end result. So the course correction is a really valuable function of the off-season. And last, but definitely not least, is time to recharge. Not just to recharge physically, but mentally as well. I've got some dear friends that work for large wrestling organizations that offer no off-season whatsoever. And the physical state of deterioration of their bodies because they have no off-season to rest and recharge is stark when you compare it to those who are allowed periods of time for their body to recover naturally before they return to the grind later on. I can think of three of my busiest friends who only ever get an off-season when they're injured. Injury forces them to take time off, and that really isn't downtime. That's time that needs to be spent recuperating and rehabilitating an injury. It's not true downtime like an off-season would put forth, and that can be very, very taxing. And not just for physical reasons, but mental ones as well. I think pro wrestling would really benefit from having an off-season across the board. because in addition to all the athletes in the ring doing what they do and risking physical harm and injury all the time, there's the entire team behind the curtain, whether they're involved creatively or in production tasks or any other aspect of a professional wrestling organization, who need time to recharge their creative batteries. If that sounds like something you're going through this time of year, and you need some ideas on how to overcome your wrestling burnout, don't sweat it. We got a video about that. No matter what job you fulfill in the world of professional wrestling, it's entirely possible to feel burnt out. And an off-season allows for us to recharge our batteries, as well as to recharge our bodies, so we're ready to go back at it again when the off-season comes to an end. Sometimes, just having that separation from the ensemble or team of people that you work with year-round can allow you enough time and distance to remember all the things you like best about them and forget all the things that drive you nuts about them. Definitely not referring to anybody at Chikara when I say that. It was completely anonymous, those remarks. Two things I don't mind sharing with you about Chikara's off-season every year. Number one, it feels like it is never long enough. And number two, by the end of it, I can't wait to get back to work. And this year's will be no different. So starting this week, I gotta be hitting the ring way harder than before. And if you watched my New Year's resolutions video, I've gotta be hitting the gym ever harder too. Because my off-season is at an end. And no matter where you're at, off-season or on-season, I'll still be here for you every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You keep on being awesome. I will keep on making the videos, and together, we will keep on faking it.